Well, hello there, everyone. Yeah, talk about safe for what you call for love. You know, does the word love basically contain only four letters, or if it's five letters? And if you want to go ahead and add what you call you have right here, but have right here is the T-shirt right here, and we can see that right there. That right there says love. If we can see that, that says love right there. And how many of us wanted to wear that? You know, for like love of how we want to phrase. So we're say talk about for love though. And if it's going to be love stars, but you know, if we were to add an extra O, you know, to this love right here, you know, in case of anybody that may want to wear, if love were to contain maybe five letters or maybe seven letters, and when it's like, yeah, you really had to open your arms wide just for it to happen. But the way I think about it too is that, yeah, for like what we call love right there, does love necessarily represent for feeling? Or does it necessarily mean this tour that love, you know, yeah, love a bye or something like that, or love a hello? I'm like, yeah, you know, if we want to call it like the way of how we want to express our nicknames also. But what we call that necessary, and I know that there's other discussions of how we want to talk about love though, but let's just say that if this love of the matter is only going to be going on for about maybe, you know, 3 or 4 weeks. So let's just say if somebody only loves you just because you're working on a project, or maybe just because it's your birthday, you know, it's your anniversary, and so that's why people are being all nice and kind to you, and you know, offering you, you know, a gift or something like that. But still, though, that for how we want to pronounce, you know, for love, because I know that most of us have probably been there to where that one know about. You say for the L and then the O, you know, the O right here. You really had to open your arms wide just for it to happen. So it's like, say, yeah, the O, you know, the O right there, and then the V, and then the E. But the way I think about it too is that if you want to go ahead and add, you know, about, you know, three more extra O's to the love or something like that to equal to seven, and how many of us maybe think it's to where if you're going to greet somebody just by a handshake. And you know, like I say that, you know, yeah, that, you know, is love only four letters or could it be five? And I say, yeah, well, you know, really, I guess if you say, if you really want to surprise somebody, just I say, peek-a-boo, I love you. So yeah, that, you know, in case of anybody, yeah, especially for a proposal for maybe in like an engagement that, you know, how many of us are going to maybe use that, you know, the shirt to wear that you're going to maybe hide the engagement ring, you know, before you propose that you're going to maybe use a shirt right here and something that, yeah, for like love stars. So how many of us have thought of that to wear that ways of how you want to express your feeling and how you want to propose is that, yeah, that, you know, are we going to see love maybe written in the air? I'm like, yeah. In case if anybody say that, you know, if you're going to be proposing to your spouse, and then let's just say if you hand them maybe an ice cream or maybe a coffee, and you're likely wondering to where are you going to put the ring? You know, just to ask them, you know, say yeah, you know, to you know, ask them that you're going to marry, and you know, it's likely so far as you know for engagement. But most of the time, we hear about that most guys should have to do that. And I guess in case if anybody that may want to where that, yeah, that the guys would need to propose, you know, the gentleman. But you have right here, like you have right here for love right here. And so we have right here for love, but really, you know, there's love. You had to open your arms wide, you know, just for it to happen. So in case of anybody that to say that if you want to kind of like make that like a little joke, yeah, it's like say that you really had to open your arms wide just for it to happen. But you know, yeah, that in case of anybody say that, yeah, what if you know, what about, you know, like, yeah, in case of anybody that may say that before you propose to your spouse to make sure you have a nice clean shave and that you look nice. And so I say, yeah, you know, and like ways of how you want to say how you want to you ask a spouse you for marriage or if it's anything about going on a date or something like that. But so far as, you know, really, do you really have to open your arms wide just for it to happen? So in case if anybody were to ask me that, you know, yeah, love, though. That most of the time with love, that it's usually four letters long. And it's like say for the L-O-V-E. And let's just say that, you know, I'm like, where does I come from? And the I guess, basically comes from whenever you're connected to a partner. So I guess I love. And so in case if anybody say, do you really have to open your arms wide just for that to happen? Or is this like, say, you know, for I, and it's sort of sign language if you want to give it to somebody necessarily. And it's like, say, for I guess if you're just going to smile like this and say, I, or if it's, when you want to try to get somebody's attention just by waving like that, I love you. Or if it's so in case of anybody that may want to, love. And so it's to say that, if this right here were to say me love, or I love, or we love. And half the time you're like, say, do I really have to open my arms wide just for it to happen? So in case of anybody that may want to hear certain stories of how we want to talk about our proposals, and as well as how did you meet this person. But in case if anybody were to ask, is that you can love contain up to 7 letters and 2 O's and 1 I, maybe with a heart on the top or something like that. But the way I think about it, in case if anybody were asked, we just kind of make that like a tease, is to word it, you put 2 O's right there. You'll put 2 O's. This only contains 1 O, but if you add an extra O right there, and besides the extra V, I'm like, it would be pronounced love. It would not be pronounced lovey or something like that, or love. It would be pronounced love. But, with the 2 O's, and in case of anybody that may want to wear, 2 O's, that means that you are connected to a partner, and basically that, whenever the B and then the E comes along, it's like, for I, yeah. So in case of anybody, say, yeah. So how, if we're going to be signing anybody that I guess, not necessarily about, how, in certain ways, if you want to just use this as a, just say, I love, and at you or something like, have the 2 fingers like this. It's like if you're pointing the sign, say, the sign, for I and you, I, you. And so I guess if we're going to be using love, love. And so let's just say that, and then the stars right here. So I'm sure they say that there's more than 1 star. And I guess, in case of anybody that may want to wear, I made this shirt around Valentine's Day. But still, though, that in case of anybody that's going to maybe have any weddings or dates going on, maybe around the summertime, towards 4th of July holiday or sometime like that, later on in the fall, then they can maybe have some practice with, the tease. And, tease, I'm like, the tease. That, why do you want to put an extra O or 2 extra O's in the word love? And like, say, how many of us guys that really, really know what love is? And a lot of times, for 2018, I keep thinking too, in case if anybody were warned to work, that if there's any love sites that you think that you and then you start talking about, really, I am a college student, in case if anybody knew that. And I seem to be busy all the time with classes, but still, that whenever it comes to dating, though, that in case of anybody were asked, in case of the girls were to ask me the question to her, that, a lot of times, what do you think about ladies like Neil? What do you think love is? And I can better probably tell them it's about the connection. It's about the trust and the connection. And so you have right here, this right here, I don't know if everybody has seen this right here already, but I would have posted it right around Valentine's Day. But the guy right there is this lady right here, this girl example right here, of staring at the stars at nighttime, for how we connect. That's supposed to be kind of like an example right there of classmates right there. But talk about for like classmates. And I have right there that shirt right there that represents for love right there. So in case if anybody can see that right there, do you really have to open your arms wide just for it to happen? Or say, and I know some people say that, you open your mouth, and then, you need to open your mouth so people can hear you, it seems like, You really have to open your arms wide just for it to happen. But the way I think about it, though, that maybe that you're not going to use love whenever you open your mouth wide, and that more likely that, you know, if there's anything you say, say so far as love. But on the other hand, that with talking about love, though, if we really had to open our arms wide just for it to happen, that you're likely weren't to where that who has said anything about turning O sideways. And I say, yeah, well, if that's how you like your pancakes, that the first breakfast that you may have one morning with your partner, that might say that, you know, how do you want your pancakes served? But still, you know, I guess the only way, reason maybe you want to put in extra O in love, maybe all of fact about is to where that, you know, yeah, does that show feeling or does that just show called like what you call that, you know, the basic remembrance, how you met this person and what do you think about them? And so in case of anybody that may say, you know, especially on the text messaging, if you're going to be writing messages to somebody and, you know, they're going to say it's like love, you know, that seems like it says the same thing. And half the time you weren't to where that's really you saying it. Or say, if you want to say it again, but then this time include a little bit of sugar on the top, include like a sticker on the top, you know, a sticker next to the message and then say something like, you know, love, such as, you know, are you really going to get on your knees and say, open your arms wide just for it to happen? but the way I think about it too, they have right here for love right here. If we can see that right there, you know, for love. But yeah, I might, you know, on this other side right here, I can go ahead and so we can all see this right here. But if we can see it very clearly that, yeah, you know, I'm just trying to, it's this T-shirt right here from Valentine's Day right here. But in case of anybody say that, yeah, love, you really have to open your arms wide just for it to happen. Or I was like, no, you can just hold it like this and like, yeah, you know. And yeah, and a lot of ladies will probably say, if you're going to be out at dinner, and you know, I say, I can't see your whole face. You know, why are you covering your face up like that? So most gentlemen will more likely do this whenever they get ready to show their partner something, or if they're getting ready to, you know, ask them a question. It's like, you know, would you quit holding your shirt like that so I can see you? But, so yeah, that I know that, with you know, anything about which call it certain moments is to where that like, oh yeah, that there's something like, yeah, you're gonna maybe hold your shirt like this. Like, what are you doing? You know, why are you holding your shirt like that, honey? But I'm like, yeah, well, I want to surprise you. So yeah, in case of anybody that may want to where that you know, sometimes that you know, if you're trying to give somebody something and maybe a if you're trying to give them, you know, maybe a little bit of money or maybe a gift card or maybe that if you want to show them something that you made for them or something like that, I'm like, yeah, you thought that the lady was going to not accept it just because, or the guy was not going to accept it just because that they don't like it, or if it's really the thought that counts, you know. But the way I think about it too is that, you know, for our expressions about whenever you're getting ready to give somebody something and it's like you're going to, maybe, you know, hide it maybe under the shirt or something, like you hide it somewhere before you give it to them. And, you know, yeah, you know, and you may tell them the story too about as to where you didn't give it to them right away because, yeah, you were too shy really just to speak up about it. But what are the, and I know that in case of anybody were say, if you're going to go ahead and do that to where that you're going to add an extra E or an extra O in this four-letter word, so you're for love right here. And you're going to say that, you know, just to explain the story, just to make it short as to where that, yeah, that I kept thinking that you weren't going to like it or that, you know, it was just not the right time, you know, or that we were all busy with something. So how can we really explain to everybody else about, you know, we're all going to be busy with stuff, but that we're all going to be busy with something. But then still, though, if you're trying to tell somebody something important, try and get something off your mind and then you're like, thinking as to where that, you know, I would have told you, yeah, I would have told you you were at the meeting, but then, you know, so yeah, that, you know, something that's been on your mind for about a week or maybe for about 4 or 5 weeks, and then you gradually get off your mind just by, you know, getting the person's attention, getting your partner's attention. So it's like, yeah, you know, so I guess How do we handle that if they get mad at you too for not telling you any sooner? But I guess it's the best advice is to where, listen to each other, instead of being busy almost all the time and just kind of like, moving your head around like that, any source of distraction. That what are the best ways of how to get somebody's attention? Let's just say if you show them something like this right here, and let's just say if it looked different. And you put it on there, and maybe if you put two O's right there, and they're like, what's that all about? Like, I didn't see anything. Oh, I didn't see anything. So, you're going to show them something, and then say, something that gets their attention. And sometimes, you really have to open your arms wide just for it to happen, huh? You really have to open your arms wide. I'm like, how wide? But but talk about for love, though, that that's what something I was thinking about is that, if love could contain, five or maybe seven letters, and if you want to add that maybe two or three extra O's in there, and you likely say that, some ladies that say that, God, you don't even know what love is. But still, though, it shows like for the source of connection, but I'll tell you one thing, I guess you can really still love somebody, even though if you're not married yet, even though if you only see each other maybe like once a week or something like that, the source of friendship, the source of connection it is. Family and friends that get to know you best as well. So it's like, I was thinking about that just to kind of make it but let's just say if it was an actual story, if it really happened to where with love, though, that you may have heard that a number of times about love. But let's just say the best ways of how to remember that it's not going to be highlighted in red at this time. And maybe if it's going to be highlighted in purple. So in case if you have any ladies or maybe a gentleman that's going to say that, the word love is supposed to be written you're supposed to change the color just a little bit. Or that, the way guys are going to handle their, which call their relationship about how they explain about what love is. And let's just say that, somebody like me, who's a graphic artist, can maybe say that, love, though, that they're going to maybe include maybe a period at the very end, or maybe if they're going to add maybe a Y, such as my love for you or something like that. And so it's like, you look at all the other examples and you're like, I don't think I did it right. Well, I'm going to go ahead and why are you doing that? Oh, doing what? I didn't see anything. No. Why are you covering your face up like that? Covering my face up like this? Oh, well. Apparently, my work does not match with all the others, but I tell you what. What are you trying to say? I'm trying to say I am, little brother, and I'm just trying to show my skill. And, little brother... So, you're going to, whenever you're talking to somebody, talking to your partner, it's possible that they're going to repeat a little bit of what you said, but then they're kind of looking at what? You want to say that again? For what I'm trying to do is that, we've seen this before, but, how many of us have heard that before as to where you really had to open your arms? But, thanks for watching, everyone, and have a great day.